Hi everyone, welcome y'all. So in the today's video, I'm going to show you how we can validate JSON schema in Cypress. So basically the JSON schema will provide a format for JSON data. So for example, I will show you. So let us say this is my JSON data, which we have, so which contains a user ID. We have something called title, user ID, ID, title and completed, right? So this is the data currently we have in the JSON. Now, if you have this data like this in the JSON, we need a schema. So we should have some schema for that. So if its schema is defined and according to the schema only, we can have data in the JSON response. Okay. So for the schema for this particular response is like this. So you can see here, user ID, we have mentioned one here. So if I look at the properties of user ID, you can see this is a properties tag. Inside this, whatever the properties are there, like user ID, ID, title, completed, everything will be part of the properties. So in the properties, like say if a user ID is equal to one, right? So the user ID type is what? Number. So this is a schema. So user ID type equal to number. This is specified in the schema. So accordingly, we can pass only the number for this user ID. We cannot pass any other data type of data. Similarly, if I look at here, ID. So the ID attribute, the type is what? Again, it is a number. So here we can pass only number. So we cannot pass any other type of data. So if I look at the title here, right? So title is an attribute here, property. So the type of title is what? String. So we can pass only string for the title. So here the title value is a string. We cannot pass any other type of data. Similarly, if I look at the completed, so this is the property. The type of the property is what? Boolean. And if it is a Boolean, so we can pass only true or false for this particular property or attribute. So what kind of data we have to store in the JSON, that is decided by the schema. Okay. So now what we need to validate here is whatever the response we got it here from the HTTP request. So this particular response is created according to the schema or not, or any mismatches are there or not. So that we need to validate. So whatever data we have captured here in the response, whatever we got here, that should be according to the schema defined or not. That we need to validate. So that is called schema validation. Okay. So first I will show you how we can do this in the Postman tool. And same thing we can achieve by using Cypress. So first I will show you the same thing in Postman tool. If I go to the Postman tool, now again, I'll take the same kind of request, get all products. And when you send this request, so you got all the products information which are available in the database. Now I want to verify this response again as the schema, which is exactly defined or not. According to the schema, we got the response or not. I want to verify that. So for that, what we need to do is, if it is a Postman tool, we need to add validation scripts inside the test tab. Here you can see the test tab. So here I have added something called, first we need to define the schema. For that particular response, we have to define the schema in a variable called schema. So this is all about schema of the particular response. And once you define the schema, then we have to capture the response. Whatever response we captured after sending the result, the whole body response I have captured into the variable. This is JSON data is a variable I have created. And pm.response.json, this particular method will capture the entire response into this variable. So these are the two prerequisites. So first we need to have entire schema. The second thing is what? We need to have entire body, response body. So then we need to compare this response body is created according to the schema or not. So for that, we need to write one function here, Postman. So pm.test and schema validation, this is a description and function. And here, this is a validation point. So this will exactly validate the response against the schema. So pm.expect, tv4.validate, JSON data, whatever we already captured here, that is JSON data, comma schema. When you pass these two, inside this particular TV4 module.validate method, and it will compare it. And if it is a true, then it is passed. Okay, so this is the way we can do in the Postman tool if you want to verify the schema. Now, if I just execute this, when I execute this, my test has got passed. If I just go back to the test results, schema validation is successfully passed. So the same thing, how we can achieve this in Cypress. Now, let me go to the VS Code editor. Now we will try to validate our response again as the schema. So for that, I'm going to API testing folder. So inside this, I'm going to create another new spec file. I'll name it as JSON schema validation dot cway dot js. Okay, so now first of all let us write the describe block, and before that we need to have some prerequisites. So before doing this in the Cypress, especially if you want to validate the schema, so first thing we need to install AJV package, AJV library we required. Okay, this we have to install by using npm. Okay, so how we can install this? We have to execute this command. So like this, npm install and AJV. So this is the command we have to execute through terminal or command prompt. You can execute this command so that it will install the particular package. Command prompt or in the terminal, we can execute this command. So I already executed this command through my terminal. If I look at here, so this is how we need to execute. Open the terminal and you can execute this command, npm install AJV. So once you executed this command, so required packages will be installed. And once it is done, so now we can start using this particular library in your scripts. So this is a mandatory library to verify the schema. So that library name is what? AJV. So the command is what? npm install AJV. So once we have installed a Node.js, by default, you will get npm, Node Package Manager. So by using this npm, we can install any other libraries or dependencies. So npm install AJV. So this I already installed on my system. So I'm now directly going to use it. Fine. So once we have done it, before writing the describe block, so first we need to create an instance of this particular AJV library. So for that, in the Cypress, we use something called require. Okay, require, and specify that library name called AJV. And that we can store in a variable called, let me create a AJV instance, and I will make it as a constant like this. So once you get this AJV, now we need to create an instance for that. So to create an instance, again, what we can do is new AJV. So the first command will just works like an importer in Java. Okay, we imported the library. Now we are going to create an instance of that AJV library. So by using new keyword, we can create it. So this is an instance of AJV that we are going to store in a variable. I say AVJ. So this is the variable I'm using, AVJ, and the type of is this constant. So the first statement will be the importing the required library. The second statement, we are going to create an instance of this AVJ. Later, we will use this when you're validating the response against the schema. Okay. So now we will start writing the describe block. So describe and two params. The first parameter will be description. So here, normally I'll write API schema validation and a comma arrow function. So now inside the describe block, we want to implement it block. So it block description schema validation against response. Right. So here arrow function one more time. So now we need to implement this. So before validating the response against the schema, as I said, two important things we required. First thing, we need to define the schema here in a variable. And then we need to capture the response, actual response. Once you send a request, we will get a response. And these two, we have to check whether the response is created against this exact schema or not. Right. So before that, we need to send a request. So let me send the request, cby.request. And here, cby.request, I'm going to send a request here. So what type of request you're going to send is get request. So in the curly brace, we can specify type of method is what get. That is a type of method. And what type of URL you're sending. And this is the same URL. So which will basically return all the products which are there in the database. We don't need any token or we don't need anything. This is a free open API and you can easily access this URL. So let me get all the products and I'm sending the URL request. I'm getting all the products. You can use single quotations or double quotations, and inside this you can keep this URL. Fine. Now I'm just closing this request. Fine. So once you send this request, we have sent the request, then we will get the response, right? So how to get the response dot then, and here we will get the response into this, and again we'll write an arrow function inside the response. So once you enter into the response, here we already captured the response. Now the next thing is what we need to have a schema. But how we can find the schema based on the response, how can we find the schema is, there are multiple tools are available in the online. So if you just copy the response, it will automatically generate the schema. So if I just go back to this website, so this is a simple website, transform.tools, and you can find so many tools. So whatever JSON response you got it, so you can just paste it over here. Then it will automatically generate the JSON schema. So for example, here, I got this response, right? So I'm just copying this response as it is. And then I'll paste it over here. So based on this response, it is automatically generated JSON schema here. The same JSON schema, I will copy inside my variable. So in the Postman also, I mentioned the same schema. If you go back to the test tab, and here, this is the JSON schema actually. This is the JSON schema. I'm just capturing the same thing, whatever I've captured earlier, same thing, same schema I'm capturing. And then keep it in your automation script. So then response, once you enter into the response, then body, then we need to specify that. So how can specify? Just copy paste. So you can take where this is the way of declaring the variable in JavaScript, or you can also take constant, whatever you want. Schema. So this is the about schema. We just copied the schema as it is. Okay, so once you copy the schema, so the schema is exactly end here. This is a bracket, this is a curly braces, and this is another curly brace, right? So here the schema is end. Schema is ended here. So once the schema is defined, right? So we have a response here, we have a schema here. So what is the next thing? We need to check the response is created according to the schema or not. So that we need to specify here. Inside this, after specifying the schema, then we need to validate. So to validate this, we need to take the help of AGV object. So here we have already created this object of this AGV, right? So this we need to take the help AVG. So here AVG dot, there is a method called compile. Okay, so AVG dot compile. And here we need to just specify the schema. So whatever schema we have already defined here. So this particular schema, we can directly specify here. So this command will basically check the response is according to the schema or not, but this will not validate actually. So we need to also specify the response, right? So this will store in some variable, let's say validate. I'm taking some variable. This is, I'll make it as constant variable, right? So once you have taken this, now we need to compare this along with the response. So we need another statement we need to write. So for this validate, we need to pass response dot body. So we need to pass this response body inside this validator, and that will return true or false. A boolean value will be returned. Okay, if it is written true and that test is passed, if we return false, test is failed. So that I'm going to store in a variable again, constant, let's say is valid, some variable I'm taking. Okay, now what we have done is we have first passed the schema into this avj.compile that is returning a method called validate. And inside this validate, I'm again passing response.body. So once you pass the response body, then it will exactly validate our response is according to the schema or not. Then it will return true or false. And now we need to put one assertion. Expect and is valid dot to be true. That should be true, right? That's our expectation. So this is how we can simply write our validation. So this is how we can simply validate the schema of that particular response by taking the help of AGV library. So first we need to install it, and then only we'll able to import, and then only we'll able to create a instance, and then only you will able to compare the response against the schema. Okay, so now let us execute. And first of all, let's save the file and open the terminal, and let me open the command npx cypress, then open. So I'm trying to open my Cypress application directly, and you can also run through command prompt. So click on end-to-end testing, start. So now it will list out all the spec files which are available in your folder. So now I'm going to execute it. JSON schema validation. Fine. So now it has got failed. So you can see here, an uncatched error was detected outside of the test. AJV is not defined. So somewhere it is saying constant AVJ equal to new AGV. Yeah. So I think some typo mistake is there. So let me cross check once again. So this is capital. It's not capital letter actually. It is a small letters. AJV. Okay. So this is how we need to specify. So whatever variable we define here, the same thing we have to specify here. Okay. Now let me save the file and then execute one more time. Save and then executing. Yeah, perfect. So now we can see expected is true and the actual is also true. So that means what? Whatever response we got, it is created according to the schema defined for that particular API. So in Cypress, we have to validate the schema of the response by taking the help of AJV library. And first we need to install that by using NPM and then only we'll able to access everything from this AGV, and then we can validate the schema of that particular response. Okay. So this is all about this video. So next video, we'll discuss another topic. Thanks for watching.